All right. Chapter 3, Part 2. Now we get to see the super fun driving segments.
Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true.
You don't say!
Its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world, taken over by the dark presence, was trying to destroy me. It all felt real.
But I bet I can jump that thing.
Even during daytime, I was being stalked. The bridge must have collapsed only moments after I'd crossed it.
Flora! You could have survived that.
Today, I would meet the kidnapper,
yep.
And he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice.
The only thing I'm really concerned about with the vehicles in this, like,
without realizing it,
I know they're kind of easy to destroy, but the game usually provides you with a backup one in case you fuck up. But damn it, I'm so concerned that I'll, like, drive past a manuscript page, or I'll drive past a coffee thermos. One of these days, one of these playthroughs, I'll actually just walk the entire way. See how that goes.
The textbook case of insanity.
Like, I think there might be a manuscript page at the top of the bridge up there, but I'm not sure. Here, I'll go find out real quick. I gotta get my collectibles. For some odd reason, I've actually been really wanting to play a collectathon game recently. But I don't think I actually have any. I'm waiting for A Hat in Time to come out, but I don't think that'll be anytime soon. Nope, no manuscript page. Okay. How about over here? Another vehicle.
This is Pat Maine, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained.
Yeah.
See, I encountered a big shot G-Man with
G-Man.
A figure who could use a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass. Not necessarily in that order either. Now, folks.
Oh, Pat.
I'm not being very informative here, and I apologize for that. I really should just keep quiet, but I'm just so peeved right now, because some people just shouldn't be carrying badges. And I'm just glad that our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out. And if someone I met last night is listening, let me just say, I'm sorry if my mouth got you in trouble. I'm pretty sure you're not the bad guy.
Oh,
here.
Pat.
Godspeed, son. I hope you know what you're doing. Now, on a lighter note, I'll be talking to Dr. Nelson all morning. But first, a little music.
Nobody cares about me. Ain't even got a friend.
Why don't any of my vehicles here have a radio? I'm pretty sure whenever the hell this game is set, vehicles have that. Oh, whoops. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Go, Alan, go. You're doing it. Freedom! There you go. Okay, no coffee over here either. Uh-oh. Ah, it'll be fine. The electric company won't miss it. I did nothing. Such a far way to run from the truck to the staircase. I don't gotta walk shit. Hill, you don't say. Man, such a beautiful countryside. I should probably watch where I'm going. Like a glove. Tell me about it, Doc.
We're talking about that. I was saying I don't buy it.
Oh.
See, to me, that's strange, because I always pegged you as a hopeless romantic.
Well, you're wrong.
You got me there, Pat. But I think love's where you look for it. And you need to do a lot of looking, sure. But the idea that there's that one special person out there for you, and if you miss that chance, it's gone forever, and you're forever incomplete. I mean, isn't that depressing? Or, heck, childish even? There's plenty of fish in the sea.
Yeah, Alan.
Apparently a fisherman has a fishing analogy for everything, but what you're saying, isn't that a little harsh? Well, no. What I am saying is that your potential for finding that connection isn't limited to what's essentially a chance encounter. How is that harsh? Yeah, well, I guess that's a nice thought, but let me say something personal here.
Okay.
Now, well, I don't disagree with you exactly, but I can't really fit that together with what I feel, what I felt for someone, because she was the one, she was. And she, I let her drift away from me. Maybe
Cynthia.
I didn't put in the work, I don't know, but, well, since then, and it was a long time ago, but since then, there hasn't been anyone, not like her. And I'm not saying
oh, Pat.
Her or haven't moved on. I like my life, living in the past, but I do miss the way she completed me.
You can't argue with the heart, Pat.
I'm sorry, folks. I had kind of a scary experience last night, and let's just say
nice ups. Boing. I am a kangaroo. I can see for miles. Oh! Wow. Didn't think that would work. Ow. That didn't hurt. Portables and septic. Road trip. I think they make him too durable, Antok. Can't do shit to the shitter. Whose car is this? Whose car was that? Oh well. Suppose it doesn't particularly matter. AKA, mine now! Looks Looks like it might be from the 70s, you know. Up, up, up. Up, up, up. This looks completely safe. Hey!
Vermont, spying on the writer on the ferry had been a disappointment. His boss had made Wake out to be something special, but Mott hadn't been impressed. He'd gotten a good long look up the wife.
Not even the tweed jacket impressed you?
Mott had fantasized about goading Wake into a fight, but it hadn't happened. Still, he'd get his chance to see if the writer had anything in him. He'd been promised as much.
Okay. Man, everyone's out for Alan. Everyone's got a hard on for Wake.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
Okay. A museum that apparently nobody works at. Tokyo D! I lost a door doing that. Damn. While lucrative at first, the mining steadily declined in the 20th century. The seams were rich but hard to get at, and the volcanic activity in the area made the mine shafts particularly dangerous. Coffee. While there were some earlier residents in the area, the true genesis of the town of Bright Falls came with the founding of Bright Falls Mining Company and the opening of the Bright Falls Coal Mine in 1878. Although the work was hard and dangerous, many immigrants, Germans, Poles, Italians, Finns, and Swedes, among others, worked the mines. They were working in a coal mine, blah 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 blah.
With Nightingale gone and the night wind blowing in through the broken studio window, Maine stared at Sarah. The sheriff looked away. Maine's voice shook with barely controlled anger. That boy's doing more drinking than thinking. I hope you know what you're doing, Sarah. He's got a sickness in his eyes. You take my word for it. He wants Wake for a reason, and it's not for anything good.
Yeah, I still don't think that gets explained. Why does Agent Nightingale have such a hard-on for Alan Wake? In 1970, a volcanic eruption below Cauldron Lake, while relatively minor, caused most of the deep mining tunnels to collapse or flood. 32 miners lost their lives in the calamity, and all mining around Bright Falls came to a final stop. Now, many of the remaining buildings are protected as historical landmarks. Alright, there's nothing else around here. Guess I better go in. Look at how protected they are. Maybe they're just protected from actual development.
I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me.
Did he even sit in the chair?
I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
God damn it, Alice. I mean, kidnapper.
Wake.
Where the
Dick.
Hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is?
No.
I'm
through being jerked around
you
by you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello? I had to get to Mirror Peak.
I'm gonna shove this flashlight right up his ass. Did I do that?
It was close. Maybe closer than ever before.
Another cool thing that they could have done, but of course didn't with this, is like, rather than have you face hordes of shadow hobos, maybe if just the darkness itself was creeping up. Like, progressively one area of a building or area of a level would get darker and darker and would just advance on you and you would have to avoid it. Like, run for your life to avoid it. That would have been cool and suspenseful. But they would have to make it so that it was, like, actually advancing and not just a scripted event. Like, not a scripted pace. Ow. Oh boy, what'll happen here? Maybe this will tell me.
When Thomas Zane fell for Barbara Jagger, it happened fast. She was young, vibrant, and beautiful, full of life. He had never been a very happy man, and without any seeming effort, she had changed all that. Zane felt good for the first time in his life. Everything she did was another piece of a jigsawed puzzle he hadn't even known he'd been missing. And best of all, she made the words flow, strong and sharp. She was his muse.
I don't know, you just have dark shade, like dark shading, advance from one area of a level and just have it go out like a certain pace until it gets to the next area of a level. And if you detect that the player is in that area, he takes damage. I was reading chat, I swear. I was just thinking, like, when I went over the chain in that building up there and suddenly the entire building went dark, if that would have happened, like, it goes dark like that, and then if it gets too dark, or if you stay in the room for too long, you take damage. That would have been something cool. Then just have the similar effect for an entire, like, maybe hallway area. Can't see where he is. Hey. Yeah, take that. Static ground object. You can't go through this. That's what I thought. I'm not sure what's going on. Oh, another one. There we go. Flashbang! Oh, hey, more of them. Well, that was hard. Well, I am on normal difficulty. Any collectibles? Any picnic baskets? Oh, another thing. Can I just drop a flashbang in there?
The hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
Drive over it with a car. Pedestrian 5 points. Two for one. Yeah. Let's just go. Yeah, I don't need to mess with that. Later, losers! And now they're gone. check up for ninjas. Oh. Back off, boy. Yo, Mo. If Alan Wake were a killing floor enemy, he'd be Alan Scrake. Ow. If Alan Wake were a speedrunning robot, he'd be Alan Drake. Gotta sit down in my thinking chair and think. I don't know why this is here. Is this a reference to something?
Some of the Taken retained echoes of their former selves, but these were just the nerve twitches of a dead thing. Nothing remained but a shell covered and filled with darkness. In most cases, these puppets were enough for the purposes of the Dark Presence. But for anything more elaborate, as with the writer, it was different. It needed his mind. And so rather than taking him over completely, it merely touched him.
Touch. Because when we use our minds to take a step at a time, we can do anything that we want to do. Oil. Darkness just saved my life? Now, through the window. Damn it. What could happen here?
There's no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Power company be all over this bitch. Thank you. Alan Wake is just that dense outside influences. Nothing gets through to him, neither flashbangs or friendly advice, nor his wife's needs. You know. Oh, hi, guys. Bye, guys. Guess I better switch to the shoddy. Ow. I'm still surprised at how good of a shot Alan is. Why am I not impressed that the shadows throwing axes at me? Because the shadows aren't good when they're not good at throwing axes. I mean, you saw them. Sure, they hit me with the axe, but not with the sharp end. Every time the axes hit Alan, it's like with the handle or whatever, so they're clearly not that skilled.
I stared through the bars of the jail cell. Barry stood behind me, swaying on his feet, looking
What's up,
as
Barry?
Cool as I felt. Agent Nightingale stood on the other side of the bars with Sheriff Breaker. Nightingale had a stack of manuscript pages in his hand. He seemed unhinged as he gloated. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler.
Who's Raymond Chandler?
All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent.
And yeah, considering that, before all of this, Alan wrote detective stories, apparently. Maybe he took classes on shooting and marksmanship and went to the shooting range and stuff in order to learn how guns work better for his stories. So it's not unbelievable that he can make all these shots. Bird. Birds. Nothing up there, okay. Bats. Cute widow bats. Aw, damn it. Excuse me, I'm trying to work. So notice that Saints Row Gata of Hell is on sale on Steam right now. Would that be a game to stream for Halloween? October, spooky scary stuff? I mean, I know it's not really scary or anything, but it's got the, devils and stuff, right? I'm kind of running low on good material, I think.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscripts.
Fatal Frame 5 comes out, but I don't have a Wii U.
Enough. I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
I have Fatal Frame 1 on PSN, and I can get 2 and 3, but I already played those. Do I want to go this way, or do I want to go that way? Real Horror Stories Ultimate Edition. That sounds interesting. Ow! Fuckers! You're all dicks! Only 50 cents. That screams good game. Is there something over here? Or is it just a way around this giant hole? A different way around. Oh fuck. Ah! Damn it. I know bad games make good streams, but I also want to play good games sometimes. I'm looking for good scary games, but I'm not sure if
I had no real plan.
I'm not sure what I have left to play that I haven't already played.
If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
The light does surprisingly little. Is there anything cool over here? I see coffee! Oh, why did there have to be coffee? Oh, Alan, why can't you ever hold on to your flares? Back. Back, foul beasts. Let there be light. Still not out. There we go. Even the darkness protects the buildings.
In the same direction I was going, a cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
Pretty sure it already has her, bro. They didn't want to animate the buildings falling down. Everything causes cancer. Oh god. Not gonna deal with that shit. Goddamn Sonic fast. Dude. Get out of here. Hey. You turned on the checkpoint. I must check all the buildings for coffee.
Ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
Hi. Uh-oh. Ow! And that's how Alan got hit by a car. There's nothing over here, is there? Nope, nothing. I was really hoping my flashlight would take out the car before, you know, I got wrecked. I hoped wrong. There's no coffee in there, is there? No.
Things were never as simple in real life as in fiction. I had lost count of the times I had wished there'd be a clear reason for my writer's block. Something to fight. Something
Maybe you just suck, Alan.
I was filled with doubt. I was nothing like the hero in my books. Alex Casey had gone through his life with single-minded determination, never wavering from his goal. Even now, I was angry at myself, angry at Alice, angry at Barry. I was fumbling and I had no plan.
What am I fighting for?
God damn it, Alan. God damn it, Alan.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
Ow! Fucker. Where'd it go? Oh. I know he seemed legit.
Things were never as simple in real life.
Yeah. Alright, Alan, you're gonna cross this bridge. You're gonna cross this bridge and you're not gonna fall to your death. Nailed it. Gray Peak Gorge. Originally founded in 1928, the Gray Peak Gorge mining town was one of the permanent settlements that the Bright Falls mining community built for its workers. The nearby graveyard is a testament to the dangers the miners face on a daily basis. Most of the men who lost their lives over the years here were buried there, a grim reminder to be careful for those who remained. Gray Peak Gorge was abandoned almost overnight when the Bright Falls Mining Company closed its doors in 1970. And they left all their shit here. This ghost town needs more ghosts. Soinks. Doinks. Surely this tree will save me. The forest is strong. Oh, bother. Fuck. Where did the other one go? Okay. Maybe it fell off the edge. Who lit that lamp? Hmm. It just nicked me. You're stuck. Safe haven.
I needed a key for the door.
Not very safe, then, is it? Or rather, not much of a haven. Oh. There's another one of those stairs.
Anything
chairs.
Outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit.
Hunting rifle. I don't know, shotgun or hunting rifle. Shotgun. Much more ammo. Clearly the game expected me to actually be using it. That looks pleasant. Okay. Oh, ladder. Okay. Barrel.
The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up.
WTF, where are you? Get over her now. Stupid noob writer. Dude. Birds. Fuck 'em.
Ah.
This is safe.
Danger. Ah! Right.
Danger, danger. High voltage.
It's very bright in this silver mine.
Alan!
Tunnels go to Cauldron Lake. This seems like a great idea, Alan. Keep going, Alan.
Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
What are you doing, Alan? Don't stop here, Alan. God damn it, Alice, I'm right here.
No! Alice?
Alan, help me! Alice!
I'm losing it. I gotta get out of here. I'm losing it. I gotta get out of here.
Oh, hey.
Hunters were big, thick-set men, confident and at home in the woods. They were feeling good, running on beer, ghost stories, and camaraderie late into the night. It did them no good, as they were taken by the dark presence, sucked deep into a darkness far worse than any ghost story they ever told or heard.
Let's not go underground. What are the odds I'll be attacked? Not right now, I'm reading.
Behind the closed doors and curtains of his grimy room at the Majestic. The local motel. Nightingale could feel the locals' eyes on him, the unrelenting pressure of their judgment. He forced it out of his mind. For all he knew, they could all be under Wake's spell already. You do what you have to do to get the job done. He took comfort from the bottle in his hand. Please, he thought, just let me get through this.
Ow. You a big guy. Thank you. level just keeps on going and going.
I'd have to make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Alan, you're so lucky the machinery still works. Let's see, abandoned in the 1970s, or in 1970. It's only maybe 40 years old, and things were built to last back then. Night, Mo. Ah, fuck. I misjudged where I was putting that. Speedrun failed. Fuck it, reload. Alan Wake speedruns. Kick it, Alan. Yeah. So close. What's up here?
Behind the windows of Cauldron Lake Lodge, Tor Anderson laughed and held the steel hammer above his head. Nurse Sinclair was trying to calm him down without success. Tor grinned madly and shouted, "My hammer's up. Here's a friendly poke from Mjolnir, wench." He brought the hammer down with all his might on Sinclair's head. "We're on a comeback, Tor, baby."
Those guys. They need their own game. They need to be a rock band. Oh god, how do I get off of here? Where am I going? That-a-way? How do I get down there? Oh. Right. The stairs. Horse shit, goddamn birds. So well last time. Oh, there they are. I could shoot them with the flares, or I could just... That works. Okay. Uh-oh. Expected. Ah, fuck. Oh.
Shit.
That's one way to stop me. Temporarily. I gotta go, I gotta get there. This recording is already too long. Go for it, Wake. You a shoddy? Who needs shoddy? Cauldron Lake, the 8th deepest lake in the world. Cauldron Lake is a caldera lake formed in a volcanic crater. The volcano itself could be considered to be active, but it's not erupted since the volcanic earthquakes of 1970. And even then, the underground activity was comparatively mild, that despite some property damage, there were no casualties. Cauldron Lake is one of the most beautiful spots in the Bright Falls area, as well as a central figure in many of the local folktales. It's a popular recreational area for the area residents. Cool. Did I miss anything down there? I don't think so. I don't see anything shining in the darkness. Parkour! Ow! Completely safe. Stop doing that! Hello. Oh, there it is. Flare gun. Eh. Flare is cool and all, but I'm not the best with it. Alright. Onward. Why is Mirror Peak so hard to get to?
Maud had checked all of Stucky's rental cabins. There'd been no sign of the Wakes. It was dark when he'd found their car parked at the end of the road by Cauldron Lake. It made no sense. They must have taken a wrong turn. But there was no sign of them, and the car had been there for hours already. Frustrated, Mott stood on the rotten ruin of the footbridge that had once led to Diver's Isle before it sank beneath the waves years ago. The boss wouldn't be happy.
I'm still missing like 2 pages from this chapter. Well, damn. Or from this episode, that is. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Oh well. Maybe next time. Kick it. Or push it. Oh. God damn it, Alan. Oh, God. I know this part. I didn't think this episode would be this long. That's not a door. Oh, yeah. Basement. C W and T Z. Tom, you talked to me on TV, Tom. I miss you, Tom. Did you write this? Tom. I curse you, Thomas Zane. Tom. Wow. I reached the item limit for shotgun ammo. That's how much I've been using it. I guess you can say she's going a little bit zany. So yeah, when you don't expect this part, it's a little bit of a bitch. But I've played this before. And because this is already going on for longer than I wanted it to, I don't want to upload a 2-hour YouTube video, but it's getting that length anyway. I'm trying to just hurry through it, get to the end. If only Alan could go faster.
I could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it, It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast.
Gotta go fast.
I dreaded what I would find. I tried to hold on to Alice, but her form melted away. I was losing control. Dr. Hartman stood in her place. I wanted to hit him, but my arms were jelly.
So jelly.
He smiled. It was a reassuring smile, and I hated him for it. I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through another rough period. Right now, it's very important that you stay calm. We don't want you to have another episode.
We don't want another episode of Alan Wake. Okay.
Are you? Wait.
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry. Please, it's late. The boss didn't know who he was messing with. I didn't know. I swear, I didn't know. We don't have a wife. We don't know where she is. She's probably drowned. We just said we had her to make a play ball. You see? They got a writing for us.
Hey, hey, where's my wife? That was a hell of a fall. And there's episode 3. This song, man. I think this has given me my final decision regarding the manuscript pages, whether they're a good edition or not. But I'll leave my explanation of that until later. Episode 4 kind of makes me decide. There are pages I can only get in hard mode? Well then no, I've never got those ones. That would explain probably why I haven't found them on my playthroughs. I've never bothered with nightmare mode.
To the digs and the deserts of Mexico, where
All the times that I've played this game, it's always been for streaming purposes. And I always went with the normal difficulty because I don't think people want to watch me fail at a level or a portion of a level for like tens of minutes at a time or an hour or so at a time. So I've never tried nightmare mode. But you have been watching episode 3 of Alan Wake here on video 2. If you like what you've seen and you haven't followed the channel already, you should probably do that. So you can get email updates however late when I go live with episode 4 next. And so you can see all of the other stuff that we do here on V2. Or you could just bookmark our main page, videovideo.net. Because that will auto-load our stream whenever it goes live, and all of our sister streams as well. And it has links to our YouTube page, where you can see where I'm uploading these recordings of Alan Wake, along with our Steam group, which you can join to get Steam announcements about whenever we go live, and the Facebook group, which gives you Facebook announcements, and all of the social media. No Twitter link, though.
On Alan Wake. I'm haunted by the law.
Sheriff, Wake's running. I'm giving chase.
Are you seriously telling me that Ryder just took out my deputies?
A thriller, I suppose.
We're lucky Nightingale is so drunk and he's such a bad shot.
The story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I was told that Alice had been kidnapped, but that was a lie.
We don't have his wife. We don't know where she is.
Her purported kidnapper was eaten up by the dark presence before it attacked me.
The truth.
Alan.
I will stop this recording here, so thank you all for watching. And if you are actually watching this on YouTube, you should be watching it live. So you can help me discuss how much of a dick Alan is. But anyway, thank you all for watching.